बिस्मिल्लाह रहमान रहीम। ऑनरेबल प्रेसिडेंट जो बाइडेन, हिज एक्सलेंसी अंतोनियो गुटेरेस, एक्सलेंसीज, अस्सलाम वालेकुम एंड गुड मॉर्निंग। आई थैंक प्रेसिडेंट बाइडेन फॉर कन्वेनिंग द समिट एंड इनवाइटिंग मी टू स्पीक टू दिस ऑगस्ट गैदरिंग। बांग्लादेश डीपली अप्रिशिएट्स द यूनाइटेड स्टेट्स रिटर्न टू द पेरिस क्लाइमेट एग्रीमेंट एंड is keen to engage with the international community. Excellencies, despite being a climate vulnerable country with resource constraints, Bangladesh has emerged as a global leader on adaptation and mitigation. Every year, we are spending on an average $5 billion US dollars, about 2.5% of our GDP, on climate adaptation and resilience building measures. The 1.1 million forcefully displaced Rohingyas from Myanmar, whom we have sheltered, worsened our vulnerability. Bangladesh is pursuing a low carbon development path to raise our national determined contribution NDC and adaptation ambition. We have included new sectors in addition to the existing energy, industry, and transport sectors in the mitigation process. We are planning to submit a quantified, ambitious NDC by June 2021. Excellencies, Bangladesh is observing Mujib Year, marking the birth centenary of the father of the nation, Bangabandhu Sheikh Mujibur Rahman. We are planting 30 million saplings nationwide and adapted Mujib Climate Prosperity Plan to achieve low carbon economic growth. As the chair of the Climate Vulnerable Forum and B20, Bangladesh's key focus is to uphold the interest of the climate vulnerable countries. We are hosting the South Asian Regional Office of the Global Center on Adaptation, which is promoting locally led adaptation solutions. Ladies and gentlemen, the COVID-19 pandemic has reminded us that global crises can only be addressed through a strong collective response. As such, as a responsible member state of the COP and as the chair of CBA, I would like to make few suggestions. Number one, immediate and ambitious action plan by developed countries to reduce their carbon emissions to keep the global temperature rise at 1.5 degrees Celsius. The developing nations should also focus on mitigation measures. Number two, ensuring the annual target of $100 billion, which should be balanced 50-50 between adaptation and mitigation with special attention to the vulnerable countries while pursuing loss and damage. Number three, major economies, international financial institutions, and private sectors should come forward for concessional climate financing as well as innovation. And number four, focus is needed on green economy and carbon neutral technologies with provision to technology transfer among nations. I thank you all.